Hey, do you want a non-technical introduction to quantum mechanics that is not just theoretical, but hands-on? Then quantum tic-tac-toe is the game for you! This game might seem hard, and the terms I introduce can be very confusing, but trust me, the game is not hard per se, the gameplay is just a little bit unusual. I'm going to include a cheat sheet that contains all important terms in the doobly-doo. The objective of the game is, just like in classical tic-tac-toe, to be the first player to get 3 in a row. Or multiple 3s. Or just more 3s than your opponent. But that doesn't matter right now, it only matters that 3s are good. The gameplay works as follows. You don't have to place one mark per turn, but two. You put the number of the turn a subscript so you know later on what this mark's partner is. Note that this is not a classical but a quantum move. This means that you cannot yet tell whether the mark is in this square or in this square. You can also think of the mark as being in those two squares at once. That's why they are called spooky marks. The used squares are said to be entangled. Now, how can I have classical moves and score points through lines is what you're asking yourself by now. Well, that's where it gets a little bit complicated. That's why I like to draw moves as connections between dots that represent squares. Let me explain this with an example. We just look at the moves and connect the corresponding squares. So 1 and 3 are connected squares, that's why we draw a connection between the dots. These two are connected as well, these two are connected and these two are connected. Now what we can see here is that we've made a circle. This is called an entanglement graph, by the way. Now as long as you can start anywhere on the graph and are not able to come back to this point, then everything is fine. But in this case, you can start on this point, for example, and then come back to this point as a circle. But as you can see here, we created a cyclic entanglement, and now something interesting happens. What is happening is that all moves that are in the circle, or somehow connected to it, become classical moves. The player who did not close the circle, so in this case player A, is to determine what classical state this system collapses into. Now, these chained entanglements have a special property. They never represent more than two possible states. Therefore, one only has to look at the last move and the other ones follow automatically. So, for example, if player A shoots for square 1, for x1 there's no more space left in square 1, so x1 has to collapse into square 3. For o2 there's no more space left in square 3, so o2 has to collapse into square 9. For x3 there's no more space left in square 9, so x3 has to collapse into square 7. You can also think of these as putting arrowheads on top of your entanglements. If more than one arrow points to a dot, then you have done something wrong. To me, this representation also looks like a wave going through the system. Anyway, after a collapse, the affected squares are now occupied by classical moves. That's why no more spooky marks can be placed into them. And continues as usual with quantum moves. The only exception to this rule is the case in which there's only one square left on the field. Then your only option is a classical move into that square. The game ends after at least one player gets at least one row or all 9 squares are occupied. There are more outcomes in this game than classical tic-tac-toe. First, you have the classical draw. Then you have the simple win, 1-0. Thirdly, player A can achieve 2 rows at once. In this case, he gets awarded 2 points, or 1.5. It depends on your interpretation of quantum mechanics. Highly obscure quantum physics jokes? Anyone? No? The last possible ending is a little less intuitive. It is possible for both players to achieve 1 line each. You look for the maximum subscript. And the player whose maximum subscript is lower is awarded 1 point. The other player only gets half a point. That's it! Now you know how to play quantum tic-tac-toe. If you want to go back to the point where you lost me, there will be an annotation on screen that takes you back to the start of the video. If you wonder what this game has to do with quantum physics, you just got taught the principle of quantum superposition. That is the ability of a quantum particle to be in two places at once. Quantum entanglement, that are correlations between particles that are specific to quantum systems, and wave function collapse, the reduction of multiple quantum states to one classical state due to being observed. If you got interested and want to play now, there are links in the doobly-doo for playing alone or against another person sitting next to you. If you want to play over the internet, you can just post a move into the comments and see if anyone replies. Remember that you sometimes also have to say in which state you want the system to collapse into.